Hello guys, it is me, Noel, bringing you the video of a lifetime. Dun dun dun. No, but seriously, hey, what's up? Okay, so, what's this video going to be about? Now, I know I've been slacking, and I know I haven't been putting my 100% into this, but I'm back, and I'm better than ever, and I'm ready for Balearic, and for just the 100, and I'm here for it, you know? Sorry, I gotta fix this. But, yeah, so, as you can just probably tell by what I just said, I am doing a review of the 100 406. Also, let me first say, before I get into this review, that we got picked up for season 5. Hallelujah! Now, I don't want to be petty, but I do want to point out to all you people who were boycotting and trying to get it canceled because they killed Lexa off, I would just like to say, not only am I disappointed in you because you're in our fandom and you're giving us a bad name, but also I'm happy because we got a season 5, so your efforts were flushed down the toilet. Hashtag sorry, not sorry. But come on now. The show wasn't ending just because Lexa died. It wasn't happening. You need to accept that. I'm sorry. Accept it. But, okay. So moving on. Oh, also I have some exciting news. I'm getting married. Yeah. I know. Dylan O'Brien proposed last night. No, I'm just joking. I figured I'd have it on. But, okay. So anyways, like I was saying, so the 100 got a season 5. Hells yes! Season 5. Come on now. Like, you know, I don't want to say I was surprised, but I was relieved because the CW has a tendency to cancel shows that are amazing and that should be on the air for many, many years to come, just so that they could put new shows in that last maybe a week, and then they're canceled, and it's like, oh, well, what show can we put out next? Hey, here's another funny comedy about cops. Oh, here's another one. Here's another one. And it's like, really? This is what the 100 gave up? So you could have these funny, stupid shows that last week? But yeah, so CW doesn't have like the best track record. But I mean, season 5, yes, you know they know that they made the best decision. Sorry, I can never say that word. It's very hard. Is it just me? Maybe it's because my mouth is dry. I don't know. It's just a habit. It's a word. But yeah, so season 5, here we come. Season 5, here we come. Like, I'm so excited. I'm so glad. So good. Oh my god. So yeah, I'm just so happy for the cast and crew. They work so hard on this. I mean, you know, you think that acting is this easy job. It is not. I don't need to be an actor to know that this takes skill. Like, when I think of, oh, I'd love to be an actress, it's like, well, you know, it's not as easy as you think. You gotta have the talent, the skill, because yeah, you can be an actress and not have talent or skill, but then you're just an actress that no one wants to watch. Or, yeah, that's it. And it's just the sad truth, you know? But anyways, moving on, let's get into the review. Now, mind you, I have so many things going on in my head, so bear with me, because I'm going to go from one thing to another. But let's first start with, okay. I understand the kid. I know his name, Ilian. I want to say it's something like that, but I don't know for sure. I'm sorry. I can't pronounce half these names. Well, no, I can pronounce them, but once I hear them, it like kind of just goes out one ear, comes in one ear, goes out the other. Or if I try to remember it, it's like a weird, hard name. And then the next thing you know, I'm saying like, and then you're like, what? And I'm like, isn't that his name? But, so, okay. Oh, Let me start this. Now, I tweeted this, and this girl was like, are we in church? Because damn, you preaching. And I was like, yes, love it, girl. Because, you know, I gotta preach. You know, I had to say the truth. And the truth is, Lincoln would not want you this way, Octavia. Don't use him as an excuse for what you are doing. He died so you could live. Okay? Octavia, I understand that losing Lincoln broke something inside her, but she has to find the strength to get through it. Lincoln didn't die so you could just break down, or so you could just sever all ties with friends and family, or so that you can just go off killing people and acting crazy like you don't care. He didn't die for that. He died so that you could live, so that you could make this situation better, you know? But she lets that get the best of her. And, you know, I've never been the hugest fan of Octavia. Not to say I don't like her. I've never just been the biggest fan. But her, this episode just really kind of irked me. Because it's like, I understand you lost Lincoln. I understand. And I couldn't imagine going through that. I mean, she loved him. He loved her. I mean, I think she kind of found herself with him. But in a way, she also didn't, because she really doesn't know who she is. One minute she's Sky Crew, but she's not really Sky Crew. Then next minute she's a grounder, but then she's not really a grounder, and then she's on her own. And it's kind of like back and forth, and she's kind of like figuring out who she is. But right now, she's just kind of lost. You know, that Octavia that was is gone. It's somewhere deep inside her, but it's gone. Because what happened to Lincoln changed her. But that doesn't mean it should change her into a murderer or a monster. And that's why when Kane was telling her, like, this is what Pike did to Lincoln. He had him on his knees and he pointed the gun at him. And if you do this, you're no better than Pike. And then they were showing flashbacks of Lincoln and him getting killed. And it was just chills, man, chills. It was such a heartbreaking scene, but so beautifully put that I can't help but just watch it and just get chills and just, wow. Like, this episode had a lot of great wisdom. Same with Monty, I want to say. Like, Monty is, oh, also, you know, Octavia ran off. Let her run off. Let her, you know, I think Octavia needs to kind of be on her own and figure out what she wants and figure out who she is without Lincoln. Because you can't just completely erase your identity over a guy. Like, I understand you loved him and he helped you when you needed it, but it's like, he died so you could live. So live, you know? Be the person you want to be. Help the people you want to help. Don't become this monster. Don't become like Pike. And also about Monty. You know, Monty be laying down the truth. And I mean, I thought Monty was going to be like this season they made it seem like. And also he kind of was a little bitchy towards Clark. I thought, oh God, Monty, stop being such an ass. But I love Monty. And Monty tells it like it is. When he told Jaha, your son would be ashamed of you, I was like, thank you, because it's so true. If his son, Wells, saw him like that, seen him drinking, letting these people conspire to kill this kid and not do nothing about it, his son would be disappointed. And I think that was so great that they put that in there and that Monty said that, because you could see it strike the chord. And then you have the other guy talking about his son who's 5 years old and all this stuff. And it's like, I just really love that scene because Monty told him like it is. Your son would be ashamed of you. You're doing nothing. You're helping no one. And in the end, he comes through. And in the end, you see him and Monty share a moment. And it's like, yes, this is the man your son would be proud of. Because he comes out and he sees all these people around this kid wanting blood and Octavia with the gun. And he decides, start the sirens, you know, to get everyone inside, to freak them out so that they leave this kid alone. Octavia's still standing there, but he finally steps up, and I love that. Because I've loved Jaha since the beginning. Like, I've really liked him, and I like Isaiah, but there have been times over seasons where you're just like, are you fucking kidding me, Jaha? I cannot even stand you right now. Get out of my face. I will punch you. I might want you to die soon, but I don't know yet. But finally, he's starting to... I love that Kane's the Chancellor. Let me just say that. I don't want Jaha to be the Chancellor. Kane is the Chancellor, okay? But I'm so happy Jaha's stepping up. And I want Jaha to be more proactive and more helpful to Kane. And I want him to be the man that his son would want. And so there's that. Also, another scene. Oh my God. I love having Zach McGowan. I hope I said it right. As Rowan, I love having him on the 100. Like, I love King Rowan. Like, he is a good guy who's also a king, who's also trying to please his people while also trying to keep them alive, while also pissing them off because, like, they backstabbed him, you know, and he's, like, traitor. And it's like, I love Rowan. Like, when Clark's like, you are a good king, I was like, yes, he is. Yes. Like, because he could have just let his group take the barrels for themselves. But instead, he's like, no, we're going after him. It was my people. And he kills his people. He doesn't even give a shit because he's like, you're a traitor. And I'm just like, yes. When he's jumping, when Rowan is jumping onto the truck, I was like, oh my God, this is some Matrix shit. It was so good. And then you got Clark with that one dude in the front and Bellamy stopped and it's like one shot and Bellamy gets him and Clark barely stops and it's like, and they look at each other and it's like, we almost died, but hey, I love you. You know, it's like they shared that moment, that look, and it was just so beautiful. Oh my God, so beautiful. And then Clark can always tell when something's bothering Bellamy or something's off when everyone else is oblivious to it. So he can tell, she can tell. And so, and of course, you know, Octavia, it was Octavia. Oh my God, Octavia, let me also point out, is ruthless with Bellamy. Like, holy moly cannoli. Like, I understand, man, I don't, when she was like, the only reason you're alive is because you're my brother, that's the only reason you're alive. I was like, he did not pull the trigger. Yes, he might have helped the steps leading up to, he might have helped leading up to that. But once it came to that, he stopped it. He tried to prevent it. And in the end, Lincoln is the one who chose to stay behind. So it's not like it's completely Bellamy's fault. I mean, Bellamy, of course, feels guilty because he helped Pike get to that point and couldn't stop it in time. But Lincoln's blood is not on his hands. You know, he did not want this at all. Lincoln and him were friends. He did not want this. Same with Kane. When he found out Kane was going to be killed, he was like, no, you know, he was like crying and he couldn't do this anymore. And so, yeah, I think people forget that. But, and I love Bellamy. He's such a great character and I just love him this season. But, I mean, we had a lot of great Bellamy and Clark scenes. Like, okay, I hate to say this. Sorry, not sorry. But I'm kind of glad they lost a barrel, only because it means Bellamy and Clark won't be split up, because I don't want them to be split up anymore. Like, no, please, please don't. Yeah, and I mean that, oh my God. And when they were on the beach, and Clark's like, Octavia will realize how special you are, and then her face is like, oh my God, I basically just admitted I love you to my best friend, so let me, like, act like I didn't. You know, she had that look like, oh, I can't believe I said that. Like, I'm showing my feelings, you know, it's kind of like that way. And Bellamy just looks at her and God, the way he looks at her, it's like, whew, it could make any girl swoon. And he's about to say it. He's about to, you know, admit the feelings because he knows they could die. He knows that something could happen. They might never see each other again. And of course, she refuses to accept that. That's not in her mind. She is seeing Bellamy again. But Bellamy, he's realistic and he looks at it like, I mean, we've had a lot of failures. This could fail too. Just in case I want to tell you how I feel, I need to get it out or I'll forever regret it. And before he can say anything, Rowan, you know, interrupts, cock block. Whatever. It's okay, though, because we all know Rowan ships Balaric. He'd be watching them as they interact, and he's all, like, thinking, mm-hmm, yeah, boyfriend, girlfriend, interacting. No, but yeah, he is, like, a Balaric shipper. I love it. I love Rowan. Like, he is so awesome. Like, I just love having him on the show so much, Zach. I love it. Like, Rowan's, like, an older version of Murphy in a way, because they, like Murphy, he makes me laugh, and he's one of my favorite characters, and I just love him. Okay, that's also wanting me to move on to Murphy and Raven. Now, I kind of ship Murphy and Raven. Not kind of, but I do ship Murphy and Raven. So that means, writers, it's your move. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? No, but yeah, I ship Raven and Murphy. Like, okay, yes. I mean, she did, like, totally freak out on him and say such mean things very passionately, you know. I'm just saying, those two together, passion. I honestly would love that. Like, I would love it. But Yeah, I love Murphy so much, and I understand Murphy in season one wasn't the best person, but he's changed over these last four seasons. And yet people can't seem to still see that, or people still resent him. And when it comes down to it, he actually just hates himself more than they hate him, you know? And it's like, it sucks whenever Raven was doing that to Murphy, attacking him and saying such mean things, because it's like every time I turn around, Murphy's getting the shit end of the stick, and people are just tearing him down and saying mean things. And it's like, hello, he's changed. It ain't season one still, it's season four now. I mean, accept that he's changed or leave him be. He's trying to help. Yes, okay. Oh, he does what he needs he does what he needs to survive. Okay, so does basically everyone. That was proven by Rowan's people because they tried to steal the stuff for themselves to survive. I mean, of course, when you're in that situation where it's fight or flight, you're gonna fight, you know? You're gonna fight to survive. Like Raven was, I can't remember, was it Raven or Murphy that said, forget about peace. Oh, wait, what did they say? Forget about, freaking A. Forget about peace. Oh, forget about peace. You gotta fight to survive. And that's the truth. Yes, I don't know if you can really be at peace and also have within you that fight to survive. You know, like I guess you could be at peace and also be able to like fight. Like you're clear-minded. I don't know. It's just like, I love Murphy, and he doesn't deserve half the stuff that gets said to him and done to him. Sorry if you can hear the barking in the background, it's my dog. But, I mean, Murphy deserves so much better. Like, why does everyone have to keep attacking Murphy? Like, I love Murphy. Like, if he ever died, I would be so sad. Like, not even kidding. I'd be so sad. But yeah, that was a really, like, I just hate Murphy always getting treated that way, you know? And then in the end, he comes back, you know, and he's all helping, and Raven's like, thank you to him finally. And, you know, of course, that little thank you just means so much to him and stuff. And I wish Murphy would stop hating himself because we've all, not we, they've all done things that they're not proud of. And, but they still move forward. They still have to accept themselves because this is who they are now. And unfortunately, Murphy, this is who you are now. You know, what you did is in the past. You need to make amends with the demons you're fighting inside and just find your peace or find yourself and find your center, you know? And it just sucks because he's always trying to help, and it's not just for him, it's for everyone, you know, and he's trying to be there. And so I really just love Murphy so much, and I don't think he deserves that. And I want him with Raven. I'm just saying it. If you ship them, you better tell me because I better not be the only one. But come on, after this episode, even with her attacking him, I don't know. Raven and Murphy, man, I want it to happen. I mean, can you blame me? Like, I want it to happen. Like, it's just something I want to happen. What else can I think of? God, there were so many scenes. Oh my God. I also got the feels. When, oh my God, actually, let me tell you this. When Clark got out of the car and they're on the radio and they're like, what is she doing? And Bellamy's like, being Clark. And then he gets out of the car and watches her back, races right after her. And it's like, yep, that's Clark and that's Bellamy. They're doing them, you know, because of course Clark's going out, Bellamy's going right out with her to protect her. You know, he's all like, back up off my girl. You know, in the midst of danger, he just follows her. I love it because they are a team. They work together. That is just the way they are. And even Eliza said they're going to need each other more now than ever, especially Clark. Also, let me say this. Clark, okay, when Clark was putting her shirt on and you could tell someone was in the bed, I knew it wasn't Bellamy, but I was secretly hoping it was. I was thinking, oh my God, what if it's Bellamy? Oh my God. But it was Nyla, unfortunately. But that's okay, you know, whatever. Let Clark be with who she wants to be, you know. But, I mean, God, in my mind, I was thinking Bellamy, hoping Bellamy didn't happen. But that's okay, that's okay. I didn't expect it to, because if Bellamy and Clark ever happen, it's gonna be slow and it's gonna be in moderation. First, they'll have their kiss, and then it will move on to more than that. And I'll just, oh my God. Could you imagine, like, oh my God. And when after Clark said like how special he is and stuff, and then Bellamy looks at her, you're basically seeing Bellamy realizing that he is mad, that he is in love with Clark, and that he's about to tell her how he feels before they were interrupted, and it's just like, oh my god! Pollard, man, like, I love Pollard. Like, this is, oh my god. I'm sorry, but when Riverdale kind of took over my life, I'm obsessed with Riverdale, but I mean, watching this 100 episode is just pumping me up. Because Pollard, this episode, Rowan, I mean, Octavia. And then it's Octavia, and then of course, oh my god, and let me say this, Nate's dad, fuck off. That's what I gotta say to you, okay? Because I understand that the kid did wrong, he basically put everyone to death, but to be fair, he didn't know, but still, I mean, I understand where they're coming from, but he didn't know, and it's like, and for Nate to do that to Kane, it's like, Nate's dad to do that to Kane, I'm like, are you effing kidding me? Are you really kidding me? Like, I would kick you in the balls if I was on that TV show. And then Octavia letting him in, and it's like, you want blood? Well, I get the kill. And it's like, what the fuck, man? Like, oh, God, Octavia needs to go off and figure things out and get back in that fucking mindset of being a good person. Like, you're gonna let Lincoln's death turn you into a murderer so he can look at you. He's looking down on you and seeing you, this murderous person that he hates, because he hates murderers, because he hated killing and he hated all that, and look what you're doing, and you're using him as an excuse, and you can't do that. Like, I understand you lost Lincoln, but you have to accept that. You have to. He's gone. You have to find it within yourself who you are. You have to find who you are without him. He didn't make you up. You are your own person. He just opened up things inside of you that you kept hidden deep down. But just because he's gone doesn't mean he's not still with you, and doesn't mean you shouldn't live life or you shouldn't fight to survive. Because, yeah, all this stuff's happening. Black rain, the plague, all this, the world's gonna end. Yeah, I understand that. It's like, live life to the fullest. World's gonna end. Who knows if we'll survive. But at the same time, why don't you try actually figuring a way out to survive instead of just giving up? And I think when it comes down to the end, you know, like people are gonna, Jason said this even, when it comes down towards the end of the season, I feel like, you know, when they're getting closer to the world ending and they still haven't figured out a way, even, I mean, I don't know if they will or not, you know, everyone's gonna start kind of admitting their feelings or admitting what they've been hiding, like, or saying stuff that they regretted, like they wish they would have said before, that they've been regretting since. You know, it's going to bring out a lot of different things and a lot of different people, because the more we get closer to the world ending, the worse it's going to get, especially with people, because they're going to be freaking out, you know? As you've seen, they were like crazy for this kid. Thankfully, he got away. I mean, I'm not okay with what he did, and I was pissed and stuff, but I mean, he didn't deserve to die. And then it's like, I love Nyla because she saw that there was no guards, which was an indication that, okay, he's gonna die. But she goes to tell Monty, and Monty goes to tell Jaha, you know, and that's how that comes about. And then he tells Kane, and they go in the room, you know. And also Jasper. Okay, I liked Jasper. I, at one point, wanted him with Octavia. I still wouldn't mind that. And he was only in this episode for a tiny bit. But can I just say, Jasper, get your shit together. What are you doing? I really don't. He's already decided that he's giving up on figuring out a way to survive. We're going to die. He's going to live life the way he wants. That's it, you know? And it's like, Jasper, come on, man. Come on. Like, he's another one. Maya died, and then all of a sudden, he, like, died inside. And it's like, you're more than a person. You are more than a person. You are more than her before she even came into the picture. Like, you, I understand that you, in this world, when you find love, it's very rare. Or when you find that person you connect with, and then you lose them, and you're stuck being alone. But you're not alone. You have friends. You have family. But you push them away because you're angry at yourself, at them, and you're sad. But it's like, what is that getting you? And it's like, basically all you're doing is going around being a drunk and doing stupid shit and not giving a crap about anybody but yourself. And it's like, come on, Jasper, you are so much more than that. Where are you? Really, where are you? Octavia, where are you? Why are we letting people, significant others, dictate and control our lives when they're dead? That would be like Clark just completely breaking down because Lexa died, but she didn't. She got the strength from Lexa, you know? When Lexa died, she got that fight in her, and she will fight till the end. And I also want to say, if Bellamy ever died, I honestly do think that would break her. Because, now, I'm not saying because romantically, but you gotta realize something. Bellamy is her confidant, her best friend, her soulmate, her partner, her equal, her everything. I mean, he is her... They stand together and they are equals. You know, they are leaders. And I feel like if she ever lost Bellamy, I think it might break her. And you know, I'm not trying to say, oh, well, it's okay for her to be broken because a person died or something. And it's like, that's not what I'm saying. It's just, I'm saying that if Bellamy ever did die, I do think it would break her in some way. Or, you know, I just feel like it might break her. I'm not saying for sure, but it might. But I don't see Bellamy dying. I mean, if they killed off Bellamy, that would be like killing off Clark. You basically killed the show. Like, I'm just saying, that's my opinion. You don't have to agree. But, yeah, please do not be killing off my people. Murphy, too. You cannot kill off Bellamy, Clark, Murphy, and Rowan. I love them. Like, you can't do it. Let me think about what else. Oh, also, Luna this episode, you know, she was calming down, Raven, and she's meditating. She's like the most calm of them all in the midst of all this freaking chaos. She's just sitting there meditating, and I'm just like, girl, how you doing that? And Raven, oh my god, Lindsay's acting in that scene where Raven just completely breaks down was Oscar worthy. Like, Lindsay kills it, because it's not easy being Raven this season or last season or freaking any season, really. It's not easy being Raven, but Lindsay does such an amazing job. Like, she is Raven. Raven is her. Like, when she plays Raven, it's like playing herself. Like, she's actually this person, you know? And the emotions and this pain, you feel it all. And that's what you want out of an actress or an actor. You want to feel what they're feeling, you know? You want to experience what they're experiencing. And I just thought Lindsay, I bow down. She did an amazing job. Like, she A+. I mean, she really is just amazing. Great job. But I mean, that scene broke my heart. I mean, Raven just can't catch a break, man. I mean, she's losing it, then Abby's losing it, and Abby's a doctor. We need Abby. I mean, we got the other guy, but I mean, we still need Abby, you know. And then again, we didn't see Abby this whole episode, so like, where was Abby? You know, Murphy was calling for, but then it ended and all that. But it's like, man, Raven gets the shit end of the stick, too. I mean, I just want her to be okay and happy. But instead, she's dealing with Allie still in her head, IA still in her head, you know, and trying to figure out a way to save everyone. And it's just so much for her. And it's just completely crushing her. And she can't breathe. And, you know, she just broke down. And it just really, like, it just affected you because you're like, oh, my God, that's just heartbreaking, you know? And also, when Bellamy and Rowan were radioing in and realized they couldn't get a hold of Clark or any of them, and they drove back to where they were at, and then they saw this body wrapped up in the river, and I swear it was Bellamy's worst fear that it was Clark. Like, he was so scared that it was Clark. And, I mean, of course I'm thankful it wasn't Clark, even though I did like that guy. Like, man, really? Not only did you betray your king and steal to save yourselves and forget about everyone else, but you also killed one of your people. Like, really? But yeah, so, I mean, what else can I say? Like, I want to make sure I get everything because I know I tend to forget a few things, and it's like, nah, I want to get it all because it was such a great episode. I mean, what else did we have? Oh, man, it was just, like, crazy. I mean, I don't know, like, what are we gonna do next? What's gonna happen next? Like, oh, I'm so excited to swear. And, like, Bellamy and Clark Bellark are just getting more and more there, you know? They're step by step, and I just love it so much. And, You know, when I love Rowan and Bellamy working together. Like, please, more scenes. Makes me cry laughing. It is so freaking funny. It is so funny. Like, I love Rowan and Bellamy together. Like, please, more, more. You know, it's like Murphy and Bellamy, but like Rowan and Bellamy, more. So good. I love Rowan. But yeah, so that's basically it about this video. I mean, this is my review of 406. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah. So yeah, Balearic. Ah, this episode, even though they had little scenes at a time, it was just beautiful. It was just so beautiful. And just the way they looked at each other and the way they acted with each other. And she just knows him so well. And he knows her. And I love when he was like, when they were like, what is she doing? And he was like, being Clark. And I just love when he said that because he understands her. And then he goes after her, even in the midst of danger. And then it's like, yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, review, you know. I mean, this review of the episode. And sorry about my dog barking. It just will not hush. But I hope you can still hear me. But yeah, so the 100, Balearic, season 5, here we come. Boom, dynamite. Boom, dynamite. No, I'm sorry, I'm weird. But, yeah, so I can't wait. So I hope you enjoyed this review. You know, if you want to give me your thoughts and opinions on the episode, down below, comment, you know, if you want to, rant, or if you want to vent, or if you want to be talking about Balearic, I'm here, you know? You know? Also, I'll be putting my links down below so you can follow me if you want. On my Twitter, I tweet a lot about the 100 and Riverdale. Riverdale, I love you. But yes, I am back and better than ever. No, but I am back to making my 100 rant views and freaking out about Balearic because watching the episode last night and tweeting, I was just like, and I'm just so excited to see what's to come. Oh, that's what I forgot to say. Thankfully, I remembered. Oh my God, I love the Kane and Clark scene. Like, you know, Clark is okay with Kane and Abby together. Like, I'm happy. I'm happy that she's okay with it. She wants her mom to be happy. But it's like, Kane was so worried about Abby, you know, so he wanted to go, but he has to stay behind. He's the chancellor. Thank God he did stay behind. But he's the chancellor. He has to stay behind. And she's like, don't worry. I'll give my mom your love. And he's like, yes, please do. And he hugs her and stuff. And I'm just, and she hugs him back because, you know, she hasn't had a father figure in forever. And to feel like the hug of a man who cares, you know, I don't know. She just kind of like hugged him back and it was such a sweet moment. And it's just like, oh God, you know, even in the midst of all this craziness and almost dying, you're just like, you have these little moments that just make your heart so happy and that just make the show so much more amazing. And I mean, next week we got Black Rain, people dying, like, oh my God. And what if Bellamy sacrifices himself for not only the good of his people, but for Octavia and for Clark? What if he sacrifices himself to be the guinea pig for the radiation? Like, he doesn't die, but he's in a lot of pain. And Clark's right by his side, of course, and he's in a lot of pain. Just imagine that. Like, he's like, I'll do it. And Clark's like, no, no, you're not doing this. No, we'll get someone else. And he's like, I have to do this. And because, you know, of course, he also is another one who hates himself in the inside, too, for what happened with Lincoln. And it would just, and Clark's by his side, and he's doing it, and all of a sudden she puts it in, and he's like, you know, and he starts, like, shaking, and he's just, like, reacting to it, and Clark's like, what's going on? You know, stop it. What do we, you know, and she's freaking out, and finally he stops, and he... But, yeah, he doesn't die, but he's in a ton of pain, and it ends up working in the end, or it ends up not working in the end, either way. But how amazing would it be if it was Bellamy? Of course, I don't want Bellamy in pain, but, I mean, that would be a great Balearic moment. Come on. Or, oh my God, Bellamy almost dying, and Clark, like, I feel like towards the end, I feel like at the end of the season, something has to happen at the end of the season between Bellamy and Clark. There has to be, every season, we've got one step closer to that, maybe something more to that, maybe romantic. And what Jason's been saying, and Bob, I mean, I tweet about it, so if you want to see it, you can see on there. It, you kind of put two and two together, and you're kind of thinking, something's going to be going on with them. You know, someone's going to be admitting something. You know, something's going to go down between Bellamy and Clark by the end of the season. I hope, I mean, it would be nice, or no, it'd be amazing. If it was a kiss, I think we would all just freaking die and freak out. But at the same, because last season, you know, we got the hug and the kiss on the cheek and stuff. Was that last season? Yeah. Oh, wait, dang, there's, oh my God. You know why seasons, yeah, it was last season, but God, it's been so long since that season was out that it's like kind of like, was it last season? But yeah, Bellamy and Clark are slowly but surely moving towards something more. And I think by the end of this season, we're going to get one step closer to that Bellamy and Clark romanticness, you know, whether it be a kiss or an admission of feelings or someone else pointing it out and them not denying it. You know, who knows? I don't know. Maybe they're about to die and they admit how they feel or something, where they kiss and it's like, oh my God. Could you imagine they're about to die and they admit how they feel for each other and they kiss, or they just admit how they feel for each other and I'm just like, oh my God, oh my God. Like, man, I got so many scenarios like that need to happen, writers. Like, they should hire me. Oh my God, if we just made a show about just Bellaric, Bellamy and Clark, I could write it. I could have a field day with this. But yeah, so I can't wait to see what happens towards the end of the season. Like, shit's getting crazy. People are going to die. People are going to be freaking out. Shit's getting crazy. There's a war going on. Everyone's trying to survive. We're having bad luck on top of bad luck. We got Raven completely deteriorating in the head. We got Abby deteriorating in the head. We got Luna meditating, and she's our hope, and Murphy's trying to help, and Bellamy and Clark are trying to get this done, and they just keep having problems, and it's just like, ugh, you can't catch a break. But yeah, so I can't wait to see what's next. I just love this show so much. Was it not an amazing episode? I really loved it. It went by pretty quick, I have to admit, but it was an awesome episode. Loved it. Can't wait to see more. Yeah, so I am just so stoked for what's to come, and I mean, of course, even though I hate season finales, because that means your show goes on break for like 4 months or however long, because this show's on break for like ever, it feels like Game of Thrones forever. But I just can't wait to see what's to come, like, and what's next, and you know, what's gonna happen with Bellamy and Clark. Oh, that's what I was saying. Even though, like I said, I hate waiting after the season finale for like 4 months for it to come back, I still love the season finale because it like is the big thing, and it's like getting closer to the season finale. You know, I feel like we're getting closer to the Bellamy and Clark and that whole situation, and not just them. I'm not just thinking of them. I'm thinking of the whole cast, you know, the whole group. Of course, Raven, I want her to be okay. I don't want her to die, which I'm guessing, I'm guessing a main member is going to die this season, or maybe not. Who knows? People are going to die, whether it be main or not. Who knows? But yeah, I'm just so excited. I can't wait to see what happens. Like, yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Sorry, talking a lot, but I love this episode. Had a lot to say. Hope you enjoy this video. If you want to subscribe, you can. I mean, I'll be, of course, making my 100 Rand views still, and Riverdale Rand views, and of course, I make other videos that you might want to check out. Some are funny. Some are just brutally honest, you know. Some you might not want to hear, but you hear and you understand, you know. You get me. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy this video, and I'm going to go. So, peace, love, and the 100.